Hello everyone, nice to see you again. I am RK. In this series, let's see about how to work with Linux and some Linux commands. First, what is Linux? Like Windows and Mac OS, Linux is also an operating system and there are lots of distributions like Ubuntu, Kali Linux, Parrot OS and some more. In this series, we are going to use Ubuntu for learning Linux. First, let's see how to install Linux in your system. To install Linux, you can use multiple methods like dual booting your system to install Linux like Windows, or you can use a virtual machine to use Linux in your system. Some of the applications that help you to install Linux. In this tutorial, we are going to use VirtualBox to install Linux. For that, you need to have installed VirtualBox in your machine. Search for VirtualBox. Here you can see there are VirtualBox for Windows, Mac OS and Linux distributions and some more. Here I am using the Windows OS, so I am going to install for Windows. I have already installed VirtualBox in my machine, so I am going to pause it. And you also need to install extension pack to use USB drives and some other things to connect with operating system in your VirtualBox. Make sure you download the VirtualBox application and extension pack. After the download is completed, just click on the application to install it. If you don't know how to install it, I have a video about it. It's really easy to install VirtualBox in your machine. After installing VirtualBox and extension pack, you need to download the Linux OS like Ubuntu. Here Ubuntu is available for lots of things like desktop, servers, cloud, IoT and some more. Here we are going to use desktop. Here it is the latest version 20.04.2. Here download it. Here the download is started. After the download is completed, you get a disk image file like this. Now let's open VirtualBox. And here you need to click new. Now name your operating system. I'm naming it as Ubuntu. Here the type is Linux and the version is 64-bit Ubuntu. Click next. Here you need to give how many RAM that your virtual machine need to use for this Linux. I am giving 4 GB. Just leave it as default. Here you need to select how many size of storage you are going to allocate for this virtual machine. I am giving it 30. We are not going to use the whole 30 GB of memory. After you get the screen like this, just select settings and in systems and processor. You are going to select how many processors that you are going to give for your virtual machine for this Linux. I am going to give it 4. And display. Make sure the video memory is 128. And storage. Audio network. If you are going to use this Ubuntu with internet connection, you need to select this NAT network. Next, if you install the extension pack, you get an option to select this. If you are not, this will be grayed out. After everything is okay, here we get an environment settings. Yeah, I can't use the NAT network here, so I'm just closing it. File and network, you just need to add it. Here you can see that NAT network is installed or selected. Now going back to settings and doing the same thing. Processor is 4 and display is 128. And now NAT network. Now you can see there is no error. Now just select OK. Now let's start it. Now you need to select where is your Ubuntu OS file that you installed now or downloaded. I am having the file in desktop. Here it is. Just select it and OK. Here the file is selected. Now select choose. Let's start. Here this is the main screen of Ubuntu. Here we can try Ubuntu or install Ubuntu. We can try without installing Ubuntu in our machine, but here we are going to install it. So install, and here your keyboard layout. We don't need to download updates here now. Just select normal installation. In this virtual machine, there is no things that is already installed. So we can erase disk and install Ubuntu. Or you can use something else, like you are selecting the place where the Linux is need to be installed and you need to allocate memory for each thing, like swap memory and some other disk space. So just select erase disk and install Ubuntu. Just continue. Here I am in India, so I am selecting India as my location. Continue. And here you need to give the name. My name is RK. No. Okay. Choose a password, just a normal password. Login automatically. Here the installation has been started. So we need to wait until the process is completed. If your system doesn't have the specifications or amount of RAM or storage to install Linux using virtual machine in your system, you can use WSL as Windows Subsystem Linux, downloading it from Microsoft Store. Install here Ubuntu. Here, this is the Ubuntu WSL. Just select Git. Here the installation has been completed. It asks to restart now. Let's restart it. Press enter. We don't need this. We don't need to send our system information to this. Next. Done. Here is our Ubuntu desktop. To open full screen, just select here. Host plus F. Here, host is right control button. Let's change our screen size. Display. Resolution. My resolution is 1080p. Software update. We don't need it now. Let's select it. Yeah. Here we got the correct resolution for it. Now you can see the screen clearly. Let's close it. Remind me later. Here, this is the Linux operating system. Here's the default web browser is Mozilla Firefox, and the mail is Thunderbird Mail. And here is your file explorer. As like Windows, here you get desktop, document, download, music, picture, and public. You can see this public in local disk C, users folder, and templates and windows, and you can also use this to navigate through file folders and some other locations. Here it contains everything that need to your computer or this operating system to run. We will see what is the use of each folder in our later videos. Let's close it. The first thing you need to do when you install Linux is update your list or your available softwares list. For that, let's open our terminal. Here, this is the terminal, the powerful tool in Linux. Here you need to select apt update. Here we got permission denied. This command is only accessible by the root user or sudo privileged user. We are the default user, so we have the sudo permission to use this command. For that, you need to use sudo in prefix of this command. Sudo apt update. Here it asks for your password. wrong password. Here the list is updated. Let's check what are the upgrades that are available for us. For that, enter sudo apt upgrade. Here we have lots of upgrades to do. I can do it later. We don't need to update. So that's it guys. From our next video, I am going to show you some of the Linux commands that you will use in your daily life. See you in the next video. Bye.